Thank you. Sophie, everything's been taken.
Probably took them before you got there. Everything has gone wrong. All right. Enough of this playing defense. Let's meet by Jack and Joe's camp on the roof by the overpass. We're gonna go after Carl and our crystals. Jack and Joe will pay for this shit show.
Aiden, how's it going? You alive, man? Fuck, I'm getting sentimental. I haven't said that to anyone since my third divorce.
I appreciate it, but don't get your hopes up. Not the marrying kind.
Learn anything about the commander's murder?
I heard Sophie's brother mention something about Lucas's death. That's all so far. Now they have a bigger problem. The bandits you mentioned, they took Carl hostage.
Ah, shit.
Yeah, exactly. I'm helping Sophie get him back.
Good. Gain her trust. That might also help us find out what they know. Just watch out. They might be suspicious. But if you can do it, Ato will let us into the center.
Hey, Herman. Where's Sophie? Hey, why aren't you on the mission? Friends could have used you. Okay. I guess that means I should wait here.
Joe will pay for what they did. I had a bad feeling about it from the start. I had a feeling Carl's plan sucked, and yet I let him lead.
Why didn't you send Herman on the mission? They wouldn't have stood a chance against that beast.
Him? He's strong, but as helpless as a child.
It's one damn big child.
You don't understand. Herman's almost deaf. He used to be my mother's bodyguard. He's been around us as long as I can remember. And after she died, he stayed close to us. One time, the lights in my shelter went out, The infected broke through a window. Herman blocked the path and tossed a grenade into a nearby infected. He survived the explosion, but lost his hearing. In a face-to-face battle, he's nearly unbeatable. But if he's caught from behind, he's as vulnerable as a child. A killer combination, especially for him. That's why I prefer to keep an eye on him. Sometimes I wonder if he's watching over me or I'm watching over him.
You think Jack and Joe could have had something to do with Lucas's murder?
Joe, perhaps. He's a total psycho and a thief. He knew the peacekeepers would hang him if they caught him. But Jack wouldn't let him. He's a coward. He thinks rationally.
So what's the plan now?
From now on, I'm following my gut. Last time something like this happens on my watch.
If you'd hurried back there, maybe some of our guys would have made it. I thought a pilgrim like you was supposed to run like a fucking gazelle.
Barney, shut up!
What? If he'd have made it in time to help, we'd be having a party. Not a wake. In case you change your mind.
He can be a real pain in the ass. But we'll do something good for the city one day.
Bertie, to your health.
I gather you were close with Bertie.
He tried to be a poet, kept showing me his work, and said all the other guys were too stupid to understand. I never told him how bad it was. He was a good kid. I took him into the group when he lost his father in a dark zone. He was 10 years old.
That's pretty young.
Too young. But he had no one else. So I took him in.
If you manage to take out those bandits, it...
Jack Cock and Joe Cunt.
You think killing Messieurs Cock and Cunt will change something?
Death usually changes a lot in a person's life. Carl was wrong. We should have gone after them right away. But right or wrong, we have to help him. He's one of us. We'll rescue him and retrieve the crystals from Jack and Joe. Besides, I won't let them get away with killing my people. Ralph, Susie, Logan, Bertie, they deserve revenge. And Jack and Joe sentenced them to death. So they'll die. Your radio.
Yeah, it picks up static sometimes.
Go see Alberto. He can fix stuff like that on the spot.
Thanks.
Aitor here. Leave, but make sure no one sees you. You two make a pretty pair, Aiden. I'm on the roof nearby. We have to talk.
Now.
It's about saving your life.
I'll tear them apart. I swear, I'll gut them. Real slow. Piece by piece.
To Ralph, Susie, and Bertie, to our crew.
What do you want?
I don't like what's going on here, Aiden. First, Jack and Joe's bandits killed Carl's people. Now Sophie's getting ready to retaliate. You're not a part of that, are you?
But you said you wanted me to get close to them.
I'm gonna search Sophie's camp. That's why I came to warn you. Rumors have started. You found the Lazarus for me. They may suspect you of being a PK spy.
That doesn't seem like it. They seem happy to take whatever help is offered.
So they say. But those people hate us, Aiden. Along with anyone who works with us. So if they do suspect, especially someone like Sophie...
I can handle them.
Lucas thought so too, and look how he ended up. Be a pity if I found you in a ditch somewhere, with a piece of your hide cut out.
You came here just to warn me?
You helped me with the Lazarus. And I take care of my allies.
Sophie's just fighting for water, that's all. I don't think she suspects anything.
You think so? She hates the peacekeepers. She blames us for not helping the bazaar, and for her mother's death. So when we start questioning her people, you better be careful.
Thanks for the warning.
You gain any intel for our investigation?
Sophie's also wondering who killed Lucas.
What else would she say? They know if we can prove they killed Lucas, it'll be a bloodbath. Find out from Sophie when she's planning the attack. Keep me informed where you are. Be careful.
Go help Sophie, but be careful, Aiden.